Jupiter is the fifth planet from the sun and the largest planet in the solar system, with a mass more than twice that of all the other planets combined. Jupiter's stripes and swirls are cold, windy clouds of ammonia and water floating in a hydrogen and helium-rich atmosphere. The pressure and temperature below the gaseous top layers rise to the point where hydrogen atoms condense into a liquid. Pressures rise to the point when hydrogen loses its electrons, allowing the soupy mess to conduct electricity, just like metal. Jupiter's quick spin on its axis means that one day on the planet lasts less than 10 Earth hours, sparking electrical currents that might fuel its intense and strong magnetic field, which is 16 to 54 times stronger than Earth's. Something strange is happening beneath Jupiter's ammonia ice clouds. While the Hubble Space Telescope can capture stunning views of Jupiter's ever-changing colorful belts and erupting massive storms such as the Great Red Spot, it can't peer behind the planet's spinning ammonia ice clouds to discover what's creating the turbulence. This is when we enter radio astronomy, the study of the electromagnetic radiation emitted by celestial bodies. Radio telescopes collect data to produce images of things we wouldn't normally be able to view by using longer wavelengths of light that optical telescopes cannot detect. Astronomers use data from the Atacama Large Millimeter Submillimeter Array, ALMA, in northern Chile, as well as the Hubble Space Telescope, the Very Large Array, the Gemini, Keck, and Subaru observatories in Hawaii, and the Very Large Telescope, VLT, in Chile, to see what's going on beneath Jupiter's clouds. Data gathered by those telescopes after the January 2017 eruptions, which allowed them to see 31 miles, 50 kilometers beneath Jupiter's clouds, revealed that violent storm clouds are disrupting Jupiter's belts and even changing their color. Thanks to ALMA, scientists were able to create a three-dimensional map of the distribution of ammonia gas beneath the clouds. And for the first time, they were able to analyze the atmosphere behind the ammonia cloud layers following an intense eruption on Jupiter. These powerful eruptions resemble thunderstorms on Earth, and they frequently involve lightning. They appear as short, bright plumes on Jupiter's visible cloud layer, but the researchers were able to see deeper here. The plumes were flowing from the planet's south equatorial belt before colliding with its intense winds, while four bright spots vanished from the planet's north equatorial belt, which then enlarged and changed color. The analysis of the plumes backs up the theory that they originate around 80 kilometers beneath the clouds, in a zone ruled by clouds of liquid water. The radio wave images obtained from ALMA and other telescopes show high concentrations of ammonia gas. The observations match one current hypothesis about how the white plumes form. They're triggered by moist convection currents at the base of water clouds, deeper inside Jupiter's atmosphere. These eruptions appear to be sufficient to push ammonia gas above the main cloud deck to the tropopause, the coldest portion of the atmosphere, where it spreads out like lightning and thunder-laden cumulonimbus clouds on Earth, creating visible white plumes as it freezes. If these plumes continue to be active and undergo convective episodes, they may eventually disrupt one of these complete bands, albeit it may take a few months. Researchers followed up the radio wave images after an amateur Australian astronomer observed a disruptive plume on Jupiter's visible cloud belt. They compared ALMA radio wave images to Hubble telescope and mid-infrared range images taken over the same period. It's a great example of the amateur astronomy community and scientists from many observatories and agencies working together to create something truly unique. Another stunning glimpse at our solar system's largest planet. Radio astronomy is so difficult at Jupiter because Jupiter's rotation once every 10 hours usually blurs radio maps, because these maps take many hours to observe. Scientists used special computer software to analyze the ALMA data to obtain radio maps of the surface to compare with the visible UV light images taken by Hubble. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the notification bell so you do not miss any upcoming videos.